Привіт-привіт! My name is Ina and I'm a professional teacher of Ukrainian language for foreigners. I have been teaching Ukrainian language for more than 4 years now. So I had more than 130 students from 24 countries. So I would like to tell you about the obstacles that you can have during your learning of Ukrainian language, and also why do many people give up. So first of all, I want to tell you that learning Ukrainian language is a very long and difficult journey, and you have to realize it, especially if you are a native speaker of English, because for you it will be easier to learn Spanish, Italian, French. Why? Because all these languages belong to one group of languages. And if you want to learn a Slavic one, like Ukrainian, Ukrainian belongs to Eastern Slavic group of languages, and it will be more difficult for you to learn this language. Why? Because the first reason, we have completely different alphabet. We have a Cyrillic alphabet, and our letters looks a little bit different. So that's very important. Of course, for me, it is easier to learn like Polish language, for example, or Belarusian language. And actually, I'm bilingual in Russian. I speak Ukrainian in Russian, and it was very difficult. Very difficult for me to learn Russian, but it was very difficult for me to learn English, believe me. So I would like to tell you, what is the first obstacle that you can have? So the first obstacle is, you don't have enough motivation, or your goal is not so strong. So let me explain. For example, when I was a kid, my mom said, Ina, you have to learn English. It is very important. English is a very popular language. It will be so important for you in the future. So believe me. And I said, okay, mom, yes, let's do it. And I had lessons with the private teacher once per week, and it was very boring for me, because when I was 10 and I started to learn English at 10, I didn't understand, why do I have to learn this language? I had to start from the scratch, and it was so difficult for me to learn the phonetics. It was completely different, and I didn't have any motivation or a goal. And one lesson per week was nothing. Like, I forgot everything till the next class, and we had to repeat a lot, and I didn't like to repeat a lot. So yeah, and then when I grew up, when I was a teenager, I loved listening to English rock music, and I was trying to sing, and I was thinking, I want to understand, what are these songs about? So music was my motivation at that time, and it helped me a lot to learn English. And still, I'm not a really good speaker of English, I think so. And yes, I make some mistakes sometimes, and that's okay. I still continue to learn and improve my English. So you have to understand that learning a language is a lifelong process. So you have to practice it regularly. Otherwise, you will forget it. So think about your goal and motivation. Why do you have to learn Ukrainian? Why do you want to learn Ukrainian? Because, for example, I can say, I want to learn Spanish. It sounds so beautiful to me. But then I realize, actually, okay, I can learn it, but how will I use it? Why do I have to learn it? And I don't have enough time, because I have some more important things in my life than Spanish language. So think about it. Why do you need to learn Ukrainian? Maybe you have Ukrainian family and you want to be able to communicate with your Ukrainian family, and that's really important for you. Or you have Ukrainian roots and you want to feel connection with your Ukrainian grandparents, and it's very important for you. Or, for example, you are going to study at Ukrainian university, and you realize, if I learn Ukrainian, if I know Ukrainian, I will pay or my parents will pay less for my education, and it will be so good for me and my family to save some money. So think about it. That's very important. So if you understand clearly your goal, then you can start learning a language. And the obstacle number two is, where should I start? How to start learning Ukrainian language? So most of you start learning Ukrainian with a Duolingo, and that's good. Why not to use some extra, and not even extra, and all materials that you can use? But you want to go really far with the Duolingo. You will stop very easily. You will just learn some vocabulary, some phrases, and then you will understand, okay, that's not enough for me. And if you're an absolutely beginner in Ukrainian, you can start learning some words and vocabulary without phonetics, guys. It's very important to start with the phonetics, because you can listen to some apps, how do they pronounce words and some phrases, you can repeat of them, but you won't do it correctly. You will do just the repetition of this phrases and won't be actually correct. So how to do that? You have to start with the alphabet. You have to start with the phonetics, with the vowels, with the consonants, then start reading some syllables, small sentences, and so on. So firstly, you have to start with the phonetics. And there is very good news for you guys. Ukrainian phonetics is very easy. And it's very beautiful. It is, it won't take so much time for you to learn phonetics, believe me. So usually, when I have new students, and they are serious about their motivation, so we start with the phonetics, and it takes just approximately 5-6 lessons to start reading the basic phrases and vocabulary in Ukrainian language. And then what do we do then? Then we start learning some basic words, some basic grammar. And of course, you have to study the basic grammar. Then with my students, we continue learning what is the noun, the verbs, the conjugation of the verbs, and what is the most important grammar topic in Ukrainian language is cases. So if you're not a native speaker of English, you understand that the most important topic in English grammar is tenses. There are 16 tenses in English, and it was very difficult for me to learn them. And for you guys, you have to learn cases. Why? There are 7 cases in Ukrainian language. 7 cases is like 7 notes in music. If you want to play a simple melody, you have to know 7 notes. If you want to say a simple sentence in Ukrainian, you have to know cases. And I had one student who was very intensive, and we studied with him 5 times per week. And this is a very good, this is a very great tempo. And he was a very hard worker, and we learned very fast. And he said, there is not enough exercises for me, and I want to improve cases. I understand that this is a very important topic. And I said, okay, I will create for you some extra exercises, don't worry. And I wrote for him some extra exercises. And then those exercises I collected in my book. Let me show you. Yeah, I have a textbook. I wrote it. It's called Master Ukrainian Cases, Tables and Exercises. And I want to say there is no any similar book on the internet. And with this book, you will be able to master one of the most difficult topics in Ukrainian language. And if you will learn it very well, then you can start listening music in Ukrainian, listen to Ukrainian radio, and watching some TV shows. So that's a very good thing. This book is amazing. You will find the link where you can get this book in the description to this video. And I'm very proud that I have written this book, and thank you my student who actually motivated me to create this book for other my students. So yeah. And the next, let's continue. Obstacle number three. Obstacle number three that you expect to get a very good results at the beginning. And I want to say that if you start learning by yourself, you will get results not very fast. And if you keep learning the language every day, you have a person who can help you with your pronunciation. For example, you have Ukrainian wife or husband, boyfriend or girlfriend, please don't hesitate to ask them to practice with you. It's very important. I had one student who married a Ukrainian woman, and I said, please talk to your Ukrainian wife in Ukrainian language. You have such a great opportunity. I have so many students who lived in other countries and they can't practice Ukrainian with native speakers, but you have such a great opportunity, please do it. And he said, yes, we used to speak English, it is much easier for her, it is much easier for me. Yep. So please, you can find even 1 hour per day, or make some Ukrainian weekend with my love. Say, now my dear, we are going to speak this hour only in Ukrainian. That's very important for me. Please help me. And it will help you so much, believe me. Yeah, so let's come back. I forgot. I lose my thought. Wait a second. Yep. So you expect to get results very fast. I know that when you start learning the language, you feel very excited about that. The language is so beautiful. Phonetics is so easy. I like it so much. I want to start speaking the language. I want to start listening some music and understand everything. And I understand you. I had the same obstacle with the guitar, because I have a guitar, and when I bought it, I felt very excited about it. I have the guitar, so beautiful, my baby. I want to play you, I want to sing. But when I started, I felt that this is very difficult at the beginning. My fingers hurt and I don't have lots of time. And then I watch some video clips and think, I want to think the same way. And then I started to give up because I had some expectations. I didn't put so much work in that. And I gave up. I gave up many times. I still can't play and sing the guitar very good, though I bought it 8 years ago. Yep, so I understand this, what was the thing, but maybe guitar is not my biggest priority, for example, like yoga, etc. So think about priorities, and we come back to the obstacle number one. Yeah, so think about that. The next obstacle, that I don't have enough time. Yes, unfortunately, I understand that we are very busy. We have some family, work, friends, our hobbies, and it is very difficult to be consistent in something. But please, make a schedule. Find some time, maybe 10 minutes per day. It's minimum. It's minimum that you have to do. And during this time, I understand that every day, 15, 20 minutes per day is good, but you can get bored to do the same things, like to repeat the vocabulary. For example, you can make a schedule. On Monday, I learn 10 new words. On Tuesday, I start making some examples and sentences with them. On Wednesday, I will make the flashcards with these words. On Thursday, I will try to learn some little bit grammar that I can expand the sentence, etc. So that will help you a lot. So schedule, consistency, and practice. That's what you need to succeed in Ukrainian language. Believe me, that's so much important. One more obstacle. I forget everything very fast. Yes, I have this kind of problem. Some of my students tell me, I learned that already, but I don't remember that. What is the reason? The reason that there is no repetition again, and the reason that you learned something but you don't start to use it. Because when you learn something, you have to start understand it. Okay, I learned a word. I learned a phrase, and how can I use it in real life, in real conversation, in my situation, for example. I'm going to travel to Ukraine, and I'm going to have this kind of situations. I'm going to have a conversation. I'm at the airport, in the airport, at the railway station, for example. I'm at a cafe. Or I'm going to meet some new friends in Ukrainian. How I'm going to use these phrases? So you have to start making some real life dialogues or conversations that will be useful according to your situation, according to your goal. Yes, and what can help you? Of course, you have to be consistent. And of course, you can learn the language with the teacher, and teacher can help you to schedule the whole learning process, to make the plan for you, to control your studying process and do together the tasks with you, and you can understand what is your level, where are you going, and what are my mistakes and how I can correct them and what should I do for them. So it will help you to go faster. And if you want to learn a language with a teacher, 2 times per week is the minimum time that is good for you, 2-3 times. If you want to learn the language very fast, I had some students, and I still have one, who study Ukrainian language with me 5 times per day, and just in 6 months, a student started to speak Ukrainian language very, very good, like fluently, and we started to read classic Ukrainian literature. We started to read books in Ukrainian language and analyze them. We started to write essay in Ukrainian language or to retell some news, some videos. So when you reach this fluency, this level of fluency, then you just have to improve the language differently only when you got this level. And I wanted also to tell you that for Ukrainians who want to learn English, there are some standards how many hours you have to go through to study with the teacher at school or at university to reach some specific level, like A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. So here you can see the picture. I took this table at the university. My colleague Natalia, a professor from Ternopil National University, she took this table and gave it to me, and this is the amount of lessons that you have to take in English for Ukrainians to reach the very good levels, different levels. So the same kind of hours you have to take to learn Ukrainian language as a foreigner. And it's very also, some of the students ask me at the beginning, Ina, how many time will it take for me to start speaking Ukrainian language fluently? I can't tell you, to tell the truth, because I don't know how much time you are ready to put in the learn Ukrainian. For some people it is much easier to learn Ukrainian, for them it is more difficult. Yep, and some people have very good memory. Of course, when you are young, you start faster. And I had students from 10 years up to 65 years. Yep, and it was a completely different experience. And actually, everything depends on your consistency. Yep, so I think I tried to tell you about the most popular obstacles that my students had while they were learning Ukrainian language. I talk a lot. Yeah, maybe. I'm sorry. And please write in the comments below what is your obstacle, and I will try to give you some very useful advice. And I would like to ask you to subscribe to my Instagram, Speak Ukrainian Language, because there every day I post very useful 1 minute lessons, and also in my stories you will find lots of very useful explanations, examples, and tests. And if you would like to learn Ukrainian language with a professional teacher, then please write me on my email, and I will help you to start your journey and to reach your language goal very fast. So that's it. I hope it was very useful. See you soon. Побачимо скоро. Па-па!